Joining us now to talk about this, Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Boy, this reaction we hear about these two healthcare workers is really scary when you think neither of them had a history of allergies and anaphylactic shock, and they're lucky they got the vaccines in the hospital. I think that scares a lot of people.
Yeah, it does. This is very unexpected. And, you know, they treated 43,000 people in their clinical trials. And this was not a big issue. And all of a sudden, you know, you have one hospital that vaccinates 144 people, and two of them have a very severe reaction. Strange. The problem was handled appropriately in the hospital. One person was kept overnight. I think they're still in the hospital today. But it is life-threatening. What it's telling us is that this vaccine cannot be just out in the community or pharmacy or something like that. They don't have the equipment there to handle a reaction like this. And there was another case also in the United Kingdom. Now, they reported the first two, and there's a third one. We have no information about that.
And we mentioned Illinois isn't getting as much vaccine as we had hoped. How does that impact the timeline? And can the other vaccines make up for that?
The timeline is now pushed back, but we're talking weeks, several weeks. It's not going back that far. The delay appears to be minimal. This would be absolutely no surprise if this wasn't a pandemic and so much attention was being paid on this. Plus, with all the issues about shipping this very, very cold vaccine that has to come, everything around it, everything going on, this just makes it much more visible. But this kind of stuff happens all the time, shipping products as fragile as this.
So just to go back to the people with the allergic reactions, I'm just curious, is this something that puts you off and makes you nervous about these vaccines, and will all of them be administered in a hospital?
Well, it's we'll wait and see about the other vaccines.
Yeah.
Typically, vaccines are not administered in a hospital.
Right.
They're in the field, with really almost no follow-up. That is not going to happen with this vaccine. The big question is this a class effect? Or is this just due to something with this Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine? We'll find out.
Yeah.
Moderna is coming out, probably going to be approved today, and they're ready to go with quite a few more millions of doses. We'll see, because that's the same class.
Mm.
So if it happens with that whole class is in trouble. Not that you can't do it. You have it much better to going through that risk than getting COVID and ending up in an ICU.
Yeah.
So it's always risk-benefit.
All right, let's take a look at viewer questions. Can you get the COVID-19 vaccine while you have COVID-19?
No, that's not going to do you any good. The virus itself is a vaccine, basically. It's immunizing you against it. You're going to develop antibodies, just like with the vaccine. At some particular point, maybe you should take the vaccine, but that is yet to be determined.
All right, next question. How do our bodies make antibodies if we are asymptomatic? If our bodies aren't fighting anything, how do they create an antibody?
Yeah, no, this is a great question. But the immune system is very complicated. There are very specific parts, like the antibody. That antibody only works against COVID. It doesn't work against anything else. Otherwise, it's just wasted out there. But there are much more non-specific reactions, which cause fever and achiness and stuff. It's the same reactions anytime you have any kind of insult to the body, invasion of the body. So the symptoms are from another part of the immune system compared to the antibody. And in this particular person, or in many of these people, maybe 40%, they make antibodies, but they don't trigger other parts of the immune system.
All right, next question. I am 70 on blood pressure medication, and have been diagnosed with COPD. How will I know when it is time for me to get the vaccine, and where do I go to get it? My Northwestern physician, Walgreens.
Okay, so first of all, 70 years old, this age issue, more problems. Hypertension, a problem. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, a problem. So this is a high-risk person you need the vaccine. And if you don't have a history of severe allergies, you should take the first vaccine that comes up. Also, this Pfizer vaccine, despite having these allergic problems, had a very good immunologic response in older people. The Moderna one, not so much. So, you know, you got to trade everything up. But when are you going to be able to get it? That's a good question. The timeline has been pushed back. First, it's healthcare workers that are in the front, only the healthcare workers in the front line, not everybody, by the way. And then people who live in long-term care facilities. Then comes high-risk people. This person who wrote this in is a high-risk person. You will be, it's going to be a public notification. You're going to, everyone's going to hear about this. And now we have to shift it around. I'm sure, what's going to happen because of all these allergic reactions, that this vaccine is only going to be given in a hospital setting.
All right. Dr. Murphy, thanks again. If you have a question for the doctor, you can post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We will talk to him again tomorrow. Have a good day.
Thanks, doctor.
Good day.